What is up, guys? So I've been asked a couple of times to show the guys how to do a throttle body setup on the low. So this is my DC5 Type R. It is a 05 model, and I'm going to show you how to put ITBs on here on a budget. So Enkai wheels, carbon hood, FIA buckets. Let's have a look what's inside here. All right, so still K20, haven't changed anything. So as you can see here, these are custom rams that I made. They were originally that big, where that slit is, and they bolted on. Well, they slid onto here with a little bit of silicone. I've extended it for a little bit more gain on the torque side, a little better throttle response, because I did put cams. They kind of made the motors a little bit lazy, but not really. And I extended that so that we get a better response low down, and I don't think it affects it very much up top. So first things first, what do you want to know? This ITB setup cost me, so I live in South Africa, and at the moment this ITB setup cost me probably around, including the injectors, including the rail, I would say 8,000-9,000 rand, which is, what in dollars, $450 US. So it's really cheap. The throttle bodies come off of a BMW E92 M3 or E90, the V8, because it's got four throttles per bank, which is the easiest thing to do. I've seen the guys use the six cylinder throttles and they cut it off. I don't know how they do that. I haven't gone into detail on that. So these are 52 mil throttle bodies. I blanked off the injector ports over there because I wanted to get the injectors closer to the head. It would probably have given better power over here. I didn't want to go down that road. I was pretty happy with it over there where it is. So the hardest part is to make this adapter. I don't know if you can see that. This adapter to the head. Basically, you'll take the head gasket off and you'll get this plate cut out. And then you'll take this, the back of this, and you'll get a plate cut out to suit the back end of the throttle bodies. And then what we had to do, this is going to be very hard to see, but we had to give a, there you go, you can see that, a 7-degree angle so that it can pass this. So this is the DC5R, and this one comes with hydraulic power steering. The EP3 comes with electric power steering, so we don't have this big lump in the middle of, yeah. Common thing that the guys do is they take this off and they put the idler wheel. It's a delete kit, basically, so that you have this space over here. Then you can basically run the throttle straight, because that would probably be better to run the throttle straight. You get more power, better response, better airflow. All has to do with CFM and airflow and all this, that technical jargon that I can't really explain. But so with that said, you make the plate for that, you make the plate to the head, you make the runners, weld them on at a 45, and then you put your injectors in. These injectors come out of a Mitsubishi 56789. They are the 560cc injectors, and the car is currently running on a 50-50 mix, ethanol and fuel. The guy who made this plate and did these runners for me to adapt to the throttle bodies made this fuel rail, so just out of a billet piece of aluminium, and just brackets for it over there, just so that we can bolt it down so that it stays secure and it doesn't go anywhere. BMW E92 TPS. Very complicated. It has seven wires. That's a no-go. So we went with this one over here. It's a E36. Doesn't have to be anything. E36, 318, 320, 325. The TPS comes off of that. It's a three wire. It's easy to wire in. There we go. You can have a look. I don't know if you can see the three wires. There's one, two, three. And the one technical part. Now I'm going to have to try to get in underneath there with the camera. Let's see if we can do this. Is over there, we had to make a vacuum block, four lines, go into the vacuum block, and then one line comes out of the vacuum block, and then that goes to the brake booster. Air temperature sensor. So now that all of that has been explained, the most of the technical stuff is done, but the really technical part was this. As you can see how much clearance there is over there, like literally, let me open the throttles, literally not much. That's wide open throttle, and there is a ball here, especially with that over there. Yeah, oh, I can smell the ethanol with the throttles open. So yeah, that's a ball here of space. What I had to do, as you can see, I had to take the pump off. We milled this down, and we couldn't mill too much off of it because we didn't want to damage the pump and go into the pump. So we had to mill that down, and then you've got that bracket over there, which that one there, which is the technical part. That's the very tricky part. As you can see, it's open. I literally had to take a grinder because I can't put a piece of paper between there where my finger is. That is super tight. I had to take a grinder and grind all of that away, which took, you can only imagine, hours, because I don't want to take too much away, and I had to take a little bit at a time to get the manifold to fit on there, because I wasn't going to bolt one piece and then bolt the other piece, and then you struggle to get to these bolts underneath the veer. So we bolted everything together and slide it on. But the next tricky part was the clearance here was not enough, so I had to space the pump out. If I remember correctly, yeah, there's a spacer there, and then there's one right over there at the bottom. Let's see if I can get my hand in there. There, where my finger's pointing to, that one there. So I had to space the pump that way to give clearance for the ITBs. And then the tricky part was, as you can see, I have a, this is a 6 PK belt, and 1 PK, I don't know what it's called, if it's a PK or whatever, one rib of the belt measured out to 6 mils, that much over there. So I ended up getting a 6 PK belt, giving it the 1 mil going that way so we could get it over, and we're running the pump, the belt, on this side of the pump, so we're leaving that rib open. But on all the belts at the bottom, we're running the belt over there. Let me try, see if I can get a torch and show you guys. Maybe I should take a photo with my phone and then add it, I don't know, whichever might be the easiest. So let's see if we can get a camera on here. Torch, there we go, we've got some torch, there you go. As you can see at the bottom where the rib hangs out, do you see? That's where you see the belt's rib. So it's all the way on the left hand side of the belt on the alternator, and over here it's all the way on the right hand side. So that was the way I had done my ITBs. It's not as difficult or as complicated as it may seem. It's a lot easier than it seems, but it also requires quite a lot of work. You do have to set up the butterflies so that they are basically closed, so you got to tune them individually, because if they are too open and it just revs to infinity and beyond. The vacuums was an interesting story, and yeah, other than that, it works like a charm. I know a lot of the guys are going to comment and say 52s are way too small for the K20 or K24 motor. This is a K20. 52s are probably a little bit small, but 54s would probably be the best size in my opinion. And a lot of you guys will say no, 60, 62, 64. Yes, but the problem is with the 60s and the 62s and the 64s is you're going to get the power band all the way up here, whereas with the 52s, 54s, you've got that mid-range power. So it will make probably the same amount of power
till about like 7.5, 7.8, and then that's when the bigger throttles might exceed. But the drivability on this is just unparalleled. So it is the best drivability I think you can get out there. The smaller throttle, it's not a drag car, it's a street car. Yes, we all want to see those massive numbers and we all want to tell our friends how 2 liter NA fucked up a Golf GDI, which is easy to do. Sorry for the Golf GDI guys, I apologize. But an M2 or a 335 or a Golf 7R, or you know, like a real car, like a fast car. But the drivability, you're going to be living in the rev range the whole time. You're not going to be living at 6-7 grand, you know, on a daily basis. You know, 7 grand upwards is where the big throttles will shine. It's like big cams will shine up there too, and a big exhaust. And I had a big exhaust on here and I took it off because it made power, but right up top. So it made the car slower than actually faster. It made the numbers, but it was slow. Anyways, that is my ITB throttle body build. Matched the throttle bodies up with a 4-2, 2-1, so a tri-wire header to a 76 pipe all the way to the back. I had a 4-1 header, the big tube header, and like I said, it made massive power up top, but the drivability was poo. The 4-2, 2-1, the tri-wire, is an excellent header. Maybe the K24 likes the 4-1 header a lot better, but the K20, from my experience, I've lived it, the tri-Y is absolutely the best. I'm gonna start it up. I need to go to the store. I'm gonna start it up, let you hear what it sounds like, take it to the store, give it a little bit of a drive so that you can experience a little bit of the throttle sensation. It is. Make sure it's in neutral. Wait for the lambda to warm up, because I'm running ethanol in the car. If you don't wait for the lambda to heat up, what you'll do is eventually burn the lambda out. Okay, let's give it a start. So it is a little bit cold at the moment, that's why it's revving at a grand, but once it warms up, it revs at about 1500. Let's take a walk around and then I will show you the front of the engine.
Guys, to see what it pulls like, and then have happy days. Yeah. I'll do a little example for you guys of why I went with the longer runners and smaller ITBs. Okay, so first gear, 2.5. Second gear, there's third gear. There's fourth gear. There's fifth gear. Sixth gear. Like, you don't even have to, you don't even have to really like drive it to get going, which is the nice part. It becomes a dog of a drive to drive a car that you always have to get it up in the rev range to actually get going somewhere. This just has torque at the bottom. Yeah, it's not a V8 and it's not a K24, but for a K20, it's got lots of low-down torque, which makes it easy to drive at the bottom. You don't have to rev it. It's not like a B-series motor that you've got to rev quite a lot to actually get going. Like now, I'm in third gear at 2 grand, not even 2 grand.
Sayonara.